You are not a human being with a soul. You are a soul that temporarily inhabits a physical body. Astral projection is probably one of the coolest things you will ever experience. Imagine this scenario. You're lying in your bed, eyes shut, completely relaxed, and totally awake. After a few minutes, you feel your body becoming heavy and numb, and then you start rising up, floating a few feet above your bed. You look down and find that your physical body is sleeping peacefully on the bed. You notice that there is a glowing, pulsating, bluish-white cord connected to your physical body. You are calm, relaxed, and awake. This is not a new experience for you, and you feel a blissful sensation of peace because you are now unchained from your physical shell. You are experiencing a joyous feeling of exhilaration and freedom from bounds. You look around the room and see that everything seems to sparkle. Everything seems to have life, more vibrant. You fly through the ceiling and into the sky and look down at your house becoming smaller and smaller. And soon, you can see the curvature of the earth. You think of a friend of yours who lives across the world in Sweden. By thinking about him, you consciously go to him and you zoom across the world and soon you're coming down into a house. You see your friend eating cookies at his computer. He's wearing blue jeans and a white t-shirt. Soon, you realize it's time for you to go back and you think about your sleeping body. You find yourself back over your house, slowly moving down into your bedroom, and then back into your sleeping body. You wake up and go to your computer. Your friend is on Skype, and you tell him what you just saw in your dream. Your friend gapes in amazement. "That's absolutely right," he says. My friends, welcome to the world of astral projection. Astral projection is a phenomenon that is becoming rapidly more popular in the last 20 years, and even more so in the last 5. It is a process by which the human consciousness temporarily leaves the physical body and functions independently, while the physical body remains still and passive throughout. This results in observing the world from a point of view other than that of the physical body, and by means other than those of the physical senses. While astral projecting, however, you retain a very high level of waking consciousness during the experience, and can remember the event in every detail upon returning to the physical body. For many people, this happens randomly while asleep, becoming conscious in the middle of a dream. If you haven't, odds are somebody you know has. This is a very common experience, which is also known as lucid dreaming or out-of-body experience, OBE for short. This may sound crazy, but it really isn't. It's just relatively outside of the average human consciousness. In fact, we all experience this out-of-body state every night when we sleep. Most of these projections are unconscious because we are not trained to remember them. We'll be talking more about that in a bit. Astral travel was also known about in ancient times. The Egyptians called this their light body, Ka. They left inscriptions and drawings on rock walls depicting the soul leaving the human body. The Tibetans called it a double body, which housed the soul. Many Greek philosophers like Plato, Herodotus, and Hermodimus all talked about this as well. It's even written about in the Bible, for example, in the Apocalypse of John and as well as the epistles of Paul and Tarsus. Reports confirm that at least 1 in 10 people have experienced a conscious OBE, either spontaneous or controlled. Spontaneous OBEs can occur at any time, while sleeping, during sickness, under medication, during an accident, or even while meditating. Controlled is like it sounds, willingly leaving the body. Before we continue, let's talk a little more about dimensions that we established an understanding of in Lesson 7. The dimension I'd like to talk about in specific is the fourth dimension, which is also generally referred to as the astral realm. Those who have visited the astral typically find themselves in an environment where all senses seem greatly magnified. These senses are not our normal physical senses, but inner astral senses. Thoughts can actually be seen to take shape instantly, and anything desired can be manifested by means of the powers of the imagination in the very process of creation. It is the ultimate place for true creation to take place, because you are only limited by yourself in what you can create. The astral plane vibrates at a much higher frequency than the physical plane. There is no gravity, or at least if there is, you're not bound by it. You're existing in these higher dimensions all at once, though less in the higher ones than here. In Lesson 1, we talked about the thought realm. At that time, I couldn't really say fourth dimension. It would have made no sense. But ultimately, that's where your thoughts are manifested. Even right now, as you're watching this, you're manifesting thoughts or ideas into this realm. From my understanding, emotions manifest on the fifth dimension, or it could be the sixth, as they are much more powerful. When you visit the astral realm, you'll learn that it's basically divided into 3 sections. This spans across different dimensional overtones that we covered previously. They're usually just called lower, middle, or higher astral planes. The difference is their vibratory frequency. The lower astral plane is vibrating at a very low frequency. It's relatively dark and more primal. Some have described it as the places of Dante's Inferno, and others think of it as purgatory. Many lost souls reside here, but it's usually also where people go when they're dreaming, as well as where you're exploring when you are astral projecting, unless you know how to raise your own frequencies into higher realms. It takes a long time to get there, though. The middle realm is a plane full of double rainbows of vivid colors and exquisite beauty. It would be impossible to try and rationalize this place. Everything, including inanimate objects, have auras of energy emanating from them. Time is a great illusion to us, and in these realms, time will seem distorted. Many people have said that they are able to perceive past and future events. The higher astral planes are called the heavens by the Christians, and the Summerland by the spiritualists. This place is beyond comprehension for most people, but it is a very pure, angelic realm. In fact, this is where the angels reside. Oh yes, angels are real. Remember when I said you were existing on higher dimensions as well? Well, angels would be a part of your higher self. To this day, all over the world, people report of being visited by angels. This is where they're from. As the dimensional levels go higher and less has been documented. For few people have actually been there to write about them, and even those who have a hard time putting such experiences into human words. So, let's talk about some benefits of astral travel. First-hand experience gives us the unique opportunity to experience and explore beyond the limits of our physical senses. It gives us the ability to obtain first-hand knowledge of our existence. Recalling past lives. We learn more about ourselves by understanding our past lives. Most people on Earth have been reincarnating over and over for the past 13,000 years since the to-be-discussed fall I mentioned in Lesson 7. As we project more and more, we begin to have healthy recollections of past lives. Identify reasons for existence. You may even recall the purpose that you came to this lifetime on Earth for. This information can help us get to know ourselves better, overcome traumas, self-cure certain illnesses, and expand our sense of fraternity and universalism. Remember, you don't have a purpose except the one you give yourself. Do you remember what that purpose was? Flight! Probably the best part about astral projection. I've only had 4 or 5 out-of-body experiences personally, but in all of them, I just ended up flying around. One time, I even flew through space. In the astral, even the sky isn't the limit. You can glide through the air like a balloon, or Superman around the world at breakneck speeds. I can't stress enough how fun this is. If you're gonna astral project, you'll probably just want to fly all the time. Meeting guides. You can meet up with your non-physical guides. They have had many names throughout history. Your higher self, your guides, your mentors, guardian angels, or simply your helpers. One time, I was in meditation, and I asked my guides to help me with astral projection, and they told me that they were helping, but I would still have to leave my body consciously on my own. Damn spirit guides. I wanted them to just pull me out. Other benefits also include overall well-being, a reduction in hostility, increased psychic abilities, accelerated personal development, inner calmness, an increased quest for answers, an increased respect and zest for life, meeting deceased loved ones, increased intelligence and memory recall, increased knowledge and wisdom, witnessing other realities, increased self-responsibility, increased spirituality, healing, and the biggest one of all, an understanding of life after death. Through astral projection, individuals are provided with irrefutable personal evidence that we are immortal. The physical body can die, but the consciousness lives forever. It reassures us that there is a life after death. People who have even one OBE are generally transformed, having a much greater faith in existence beyond the physical. Fear of death is just fear of the unknown. Once you separate from your body, you absolutely know that you continue after death. Dying may not be a scary experience, but rather a wondrous spiritual adventure into the next realm of being. Death is something to be embraced with excitement and anticipation when the time arrives. That's key, by the way. When the time arrives. I'm not advocating you kill yourself, especially at this point in human history. You're going to want to be around for what's happening. On that topic, it's time to talk about heaven and hell. When you astral project, one of the first things you realize is that you are in control of your reality, more instantly than on the physical. If you want to fly, you fly. If you want some kind of flying car, you can materialize it right in front of you. Though, I'm not sure why you'd need it. The concept of heaven and hell came from this understanding. When you die, you return to the fourth dimension. If you're a good person, you will create a good reality. Good people create good afterlife in higher dimensions. Then they will hang around in that realm for however long they want, and eventually, if they choose to, return to Earth and start a new lifetime. If you are a bad person, full of hatred or fear or anger, you will also return to this fourth dimension, but you will create a reality full of hatred and fear and anger. Ultimately, heaven and hell are the same place, and it's what you create it to be. For the record, this is how it works in the physical realm as well. We talked about this in Lesson 1. You create your own reality. It's just in this dimension, the process is very slow because everything is more dense. You're bound by your physical body. The silver cord that I mentioned earlier, by the way, is the cord that tethers your physical body to your spirit. It connects when your soul connects to the physical body. And when you are astral projecting, it tethers your spirit to your body and you can see it, but you can't break it. The cord only breaks when you die. Everyone who has ever consciously astral projected will see this cord. It can stretch to infinity and will make sure that no matter how far you go, you can always return to your body. Dreaming! What are dreams? Well, when you're asleep, you are out of body. Your physical body needs rest, but your consciousness, your spirit, does not. So your consciousness returns to higher levels of being for the night. You do this every night. Remember, in higher dimensions, you can create any experience for yourself instantly. Dreams are simply you just creating experiences for yourself out of memories or thoughts or emotions that you have. Usually while you're dreaming, you're functioning at a very low level of consciousness. You're not trained to remember and consciously experience these realities you're creating, so dreams seem kind of hazy. So when you have a dream and you're pondering the meaning, just ask yourself, why did I give myself that experience? Some have said in these higher realms they could perceive the past and future. Perhaps this is why sometimes we have dreams of things that happen a week later. Scientist Stephen LeBerge has actually proven that the phenomenon known as lucid dreaming is real. Lucid dreaming and astral projection are actually the exact same thing. Many mainstream scientists will say that astral projection is unproven. However, now we've proven lucid dreaming to be real, so naturally, if you accept lucid dreaming, you have to accept astral projection as well. So what's the difference between lucid dreaming and astral projection? Well, lucid dreaming is becoming conscious while asleep, already out of body. Astral projection is consciously leaving the body, going straight from a waking state to an out-of-body state. And that's it. Now I have a little surprise for you, but first I want to say this. I don't have time to teach you methods of astral projecting, but I have a myriad of resources for you to look at in case you want to try it out. I really recommend it because it's absolutely the coolest experience you will ever have. Even for you skeptics, I ask that you don't immediately shut this out, especially since modern science has proven it to be real. My first recommended source is the book Astral Projection: Amazing Journeys Outside the Body. This is the best book you'll ever read on the topic. It has great descriptions and explanations of everything, including tons and tons of projection methods as well. Next, the three Robert Monroe books in this order: Far Journey, Ultimate Journey, Journeys Outside the Body. As I mentioned in Lesson 8, Robert Monroe completely mapped out these other worlds, and if you want to learn about them in depth, seriously check these out. Next, the website theworldoflucidedreaming.com is fantastic. Tons and tons of great resources and information for lucid dreaming, dream herbs, projection techniques, everything. Next, the YouTube series called Lucidology 101, Tips and Tricks to Have 100 OBEs in 100 Days. The author is Nicholas Newport, a guy who has been studying projection techniques and has some really fantastic insights on it. He also sells Lucidology 102 and 103 on his site. Very helpful resources. And finally, binaural beats. In Lesson 8, we talked about binaural beats and what they are good for. There are many, many binaural beats that you can use to achieve out-of-body states, but you should learn to meditate first, of course. Remember, Google is your friend. Simply Googling astral projection will give you a myriad of other sources that will help you find out as much as you need to know about it. There's tons of stuff out there. And now for your surprise. Simply explaining astral projection won't show you just how incredible of an experience it truly is. I want to show you. So I worked really hard this week, and I hope to give you an idea of what you can expect to experience whenever you go out of body, if you choose to.
Bursting at the seams.
We're stirring the pot now.